Hey y'all, this Battle Means by Amari back at you with another video. So last week I got a request to do a video on Kale, Khalifa, and Kefla. So I'm like, all right, bet, I could do that. These are the two worst sayings ever created. Ever created. All right, let me start off with Kale. Her design is not that bad. Yeah, she looks a little different. But, you know, that's fine. Not everybody's supposed to look the same. But whose fucking idea was it to make her a female Broly? I mean, how much more cringe can you get in Dragon Ball? Broly with tits. I mean, seriously, you're that lazy and that money hungry that you're gonna try to profit off the hype that Broly had in Dragon Ball Super? This shit was god awful. Oh my goodness, it's the worst shit ever. It made zero fucking sense. Then during the Tournament of Power, she had some kind of dream and she was able to control it and then look like a normal Super Saiyan. Like, what? I mean, is she stronger? Is she weaker? I mean, what the fuck was that about? It made no sense. It's like the writers were like, let's just do this to keep the viewers interested. Because these characters are so uninteresting. Let's just put this in there. We don't care how much sense it doesn't make. Now, Khalifla. Now, again, I like her design. Her design was actually pretty cool. It was, you know, she's a renegade, so her design fit what she was supposed to be. And I liked it. You know, due to Dragon Ball Super art, a lot of times she looked crappy, but that's just due to the art that they used in Dragon Ball Super. But her design was pretty cool. But I've never seen a character get handed power up so easily the way that Khalifa did. I mean, it made zero sense. Due to a tingly feeling down her back, she was able to just get Super Saiyan 2 like nothing. And when she saw Goku go Super Saiyan 3, I swear on everything, I thought she was gonna do that in the Tournament of Power. Just by her back tingling even more. I can't be the only one that thought she was gonna get Super Saiyan 3 like nothing, bruh. And yes, Goten and Trunks got Super Saiyan easily, but at least we can say that their fathers were Super Saiyan. So that potential went down to them because their fathers were Super Saiyan. It made sense. In its own right, it made sense. More sense than this. Then of course we have the most underwhelming fusion in Dragon Ball history. Kefla. Like, so underwhelming, so pointless, so useless. I mean, it shouldn't even have been in there. They just wanted to do it just to please the fans. And then when she one-kicked Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken, I don't know if to blame that on shitty scaling or just the fact that Goku and Super is complete shit. And then on top of that, you need UI to beat her? Seriously? Like, these chicks aren't even experienced in fighting like Goku. Is this the Goku that really went through Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z? Serious? And he's out-experienced by these chicks? He's outclassed by these chicks on the battlefield? Their experience isn't anywhere near what Goku's is. Like, how do you get outsmarted by her and kicked in the back of the head? That's almost as bad as what happened with Majin Buu when he outsmarted Goku and Super and ringed them out. Like, come on. Then we have this nigga. Nah, I'm throwing him in there. Fuck that. He is the... Out of all three of them, he's the worst. I mean, design-wise, character-wise. Like, he's supposed to be an elite fighter, right? In his universe. Can somebody tell me what is elite about Kaba? Tell me. What is elite about this man? This guy is supposed to have gone through wars and shit with the Saiyans of his universe? Where? How? He has zero muscle tone. I mean, what the fuck? And then his whole forced relationship with Vegeta was cringy as fuck. Like, all of a sudden you want to act like you care about a Saiyan? Like, what about your own son? Seriously? Like, this was so bad writing-wise. It's ridiculous. Like, they totally forced that shit. Then him going Super Saiyan was just ridiculous. Like, this dude has been through how many wars, and he's an elite fighter, and he's never suffered any kind of pain of loss to go Super Saiyan. He's never been pushed to that limit, and he had the ability to go Super Saiyan all that time. Like, they were better off just giving him some other kind of transformation besides Super Saiyan, because it made no fucking sense. They forced that shit. These Saiyans were forced, man. But yeah, like I said, these... I mean, we've seen better Saiyans created in fan fiction. You know, Kale and Khalifa's design were okay. You know, I especially like Khalifa's hair. It was tight. I liked it. But as far as them as Saiyans, terrible. Nothing is good about Kaba at all. Zero. Zilch. He's just terrible from the ground up. Nothing's good about him. Kale was cool. You know, she's different. And I'm cool with her being a little different. She's shy, and that's fine. And Khalifa's attitude, she had that raw, rugged attitude that the Saiyans had back in the day. And I'm going to be honest, I'm very disappointed that they didn't have Tails. Like, that was Toriyama's opportunity to bring Tails back and make them at least a bit relevant again. And, you know, he dropped the ball. I don't give a fuck about all that evolution above Tails and all that. That was bullshit. These are the worst. I mean, I don't know what they were thinking when they did this shit. They just handed them transformations, completely dumbing down Super Saiyan and Super Saiyan 2. We all saw what Gohan went through to get that shit. And Vegeta, Majin Vegeta, some say that he already had Super Saiyan 2 prior to Majin Vegeta, I don't know, but, you know, they went through shit to get Super Saiyan 2, and these kids were just giving it. Like, it just makes no fucking sense. They should not be anywhere on the level of Goku, who trained and trained all his fucking life, in and out of time chambers and shit. Didn't he use a time chamber twice, or once in Super, or something like that? Like, seriously? Anyway, let me know what y'all think in the comment section. I dare y'all to tell me any other Saiyans or characters that... Well, no, Saiyans. There are worse characters, but tell me any other Saiyans that are worse than these three. And, yeah, I'll see you in the comment section. All right.